Father's Day is just next week, and today on At Your Leisure, we're taking a look at all of the gear and accessories you dads are going to want for your big day. What is the newest thing you never knew you always wanted? Darren Kinder will show you. Then come with me, Stephen Heumann, along with Chad and Rhea Booth, as we explore the Everglades. It's an adventure that involves plenty of teeth, along with some speed that will make you want to venture into the swamps. Lastly, we'll follow one famous Baja racer into the wilds of his own backyard. Own the outdoors now with At Your Leisure.
Now those look like statues, but we are really at a sea of alligators. In fact, today I feel like Crocodile Chad B.
Welcome to At Your Leisure, everybody. I'm Rhea Rossi Booth.
And I'm Stephen Heumann, and we are right now are in the Everglades Alligator Farm in Everglades National Park, right here in Homestead, Florida. And this is awesome.
Yes, this is a collection. This is a game preserve where on any given day you might have 5,000, 6,000, 10,000 visitors, but the resident population is always bigger.
Way bigger, with bigger teeth.
With bigger teeth, bigger numbers, bigger length, bigger weights, and there is a little inconspicuous sign right over here that says, please, no swimming.
You see alligators, crocodiles, number of endangered species, and of course, the educational shows as well. We have the alligator show, the snake show, and the alligator feedings. Watch them eat.
So we have a little baby alligator here, and his little jaws are taped up. So can I hold him?
Absolutely.
Oh my gosh, he's meaty.
Yeah.
Oh, they make a good little sandwich.
I thought it was interesting because you walk around here, and obviously you have the big pool that has all the alligators in it. But then outside of the park, just right over here, you'll see little streams and there'll be alligators and stuff in that too, which I think is wild.
It's like they own the place.
Yeah, we are in gator country.
So Luke, how big is the biggest alligator you got here?
He's about 13 feet, weighs close to 1,000 pounds.
And so how many teeth does an alligator have?
80 in total.
80, and if they lose them, do they regenerate and come back?
Yes, they'll cycle through approximately 3,000 to 4,000 in their life.
Oh my gosh.
They have more than just alligators and crocodiles. They also have some tropical birds and turtles, but you can actually do a lot more hands-on activities here. Why don't we check out one of those? All right, talk about hands-on, Luke. Good to see you again. What do we got here?
Got a red-tailed boa.
All right, let me see that sucker. Whoa, oh, he's heavy.
Very.
People can come here. You guys really do up close and personal stuff with the snakes. You let people really hold them and look at them. Do you think that that helps people to kind of get over their fears of snakes?
A lot of people, they follow the common stereotype as if their parents are scared, they will be scared. And most people who come in here, once they can feel the snakes, hold them, and they understand, they start getting an understanding for them, then they're not scared anymore.
The Everglades are America's version of the mangroves in South America, and they're teeming with wildlife, and this is gonna be cool because we're gonna be able to get out there and see some of it. Is anybody familiar with the phrase, gentle Ben?
Yes.
Going to explain it a little bit later in the show. But right now, it's time for us to go to our travel adventure.
I've been very competitive my whole life.
For Dean Bullock, adventure is a way of life, and there aren't many places in his hometown of Cedar City that are unknown to him. As a celebrated Baja racer and off-highway explorer, Dean knows the dirt better than most. Today, he sets his sights on a new trail, though, and what he found was big, little, and everything in between.
We're at a place just west of Parowan, Utah, down in southern Utah. It's called the Little Salt Lake. We're out here riding the trails today. You know, there's some neat trails out here, some rock crawling, seen quite a few animals. It's been a great day. The Little Salt Lake, it got named that from the Mormon pioneers because of the salt content. It looks like the salt flats up near Great Salt Lake, but just a smaller version.
Little Salt Lake is a dry lake bed just northwest of Cedar City and Interstate 15. The long white strip is a remnant of ancient Lake Bonneville that covered much of Utah over 14,000 years ago. It's easy to find on Gap Road, right out of Parowan, and rests on the doorstep of the Parowan Gap, an incredible earthen feature that acted as a solar calendar for native tribes. There's actually evidence that people would come from hundreds of miles on the winter and summer solstice to watch the sun set directly down the center of the gap. Today, rock art covers the area, giving visitors a glimpse into the past and the chance to try and interpret what these ancient symbols may have meant. OHV trails pepper this landscape, ranging from little more than dirt roads to rocky outcroppings that can challenge the skill of even professionals like Dean.
It's a neat, unexplored area from what we've seen, I think. There's very little traffic out here, probably because of the way you have to come in around the lake. But it's a great place to come and explore and rock kick and see the animals and the different terrain. I've lived in Cedar City my entire life, and I really didn't know that there was something this neat this close to my home.
Of course, in some cases, it would make sense for Dean to have missed something like this, since oftentimes he's a little more off-road than most and traveling a bit faster than the average rider. For years, Dean has been a Baja champion, fabricating his own machines for some of the hardest and most intense cross-country races in the world. These battles are a far cry from a leisurely day of riding, but have given him the chance to test his mettle against the best in circumstances that few of us have ever known.
King of the Hammers is known as the toughest off-road race in the world, which it is. In the UTV division, there was 52 UTVs that left the starting line, and only two of us finished.
Now, there is definitely a difference between a race like King of the Hammers and a ride like we're enjoying today. At times, the scenery will fly by in both circumstances, but there's something to be said for being able to stop and take in the beauty in a more contemplative way. But then again, when you're traveling at speed, you see a lot, and you enjoy a thrill you can't get on a calmer ride. For Dean, they both have an equal but slightly different place in his exploration handbook.
I just think the advantage of riding in both is to get to see the different types of terrain. Their high desert in California is different than our high desert in Utah, so the change of scenery is nice.
Dean has obviously taken a more leisurely ride today, but in so doing, has seen sights he never knew he was missing right in his own backyard. And that's what off-highway exploration is all about, the chance to find what has never been found and see what has never been seen. Every experience is new and different, and the great thing about the West is there's always something new to discover right around the next turn in the trail. Cedar City is an excellent example of this fact.
Cedar City is in the southern part of the state, but yet it's 6,000 feet in elevation. So we can go snowmobiling up in the mountains one day, and we can come down here and ride like this the next day. We're so close to all the different types of racing. I just love it, and I feel fortunate that people love to come to Cedar City and ride, and it's something that I feel honored that I get to do.
We all have that same opportunity. We just need to set our sights on the horizon and take that first step on our next adventure. And then we'll be just like Dean, discovering something new in a place we thought we already knew. For At Your Leisure, I'm Stephen Humer.
A place that is beyond words. There is nothing to be said, except take your time in Bryce Canyon Country.
Dominate every trail. Conquer any task. You need a machine that does it all. Introducing Polaris General. The General is the most powerful rec utility side-by-side ever made. The industry's deepest cargo box lets you haul and dump up to 600 pounds, and the revolutionary cockpit totally refines comfort and protection. Polaris General, ultimate versatility to win every battle.
Thank you. Carbon County is typically known for its industry and coal production, but did you know Utah's Castle Country has something for everyone? Visit the Carbon County Fairgrounds for exciting activities and events year-long. The Carbon County Event Center is a state-of-the-art convention center for conferences, meetings, trade shows, and more. Fly your RC plane or helicopter at the Model Airport. Three large arenas and four ball fields invite competitions and events of all kinds. Visit castlecountry.com for more info.
Well, welcome back to At Your Leisure. Next weekend is Father's Day, and really, your dad doesn't want another tie or pair of socks. Bring him out to Steadman's, and we've got all kinds of fun toys out here. Isn't that right, Dave?
Hey, Darren, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Oh, boy, I tell you, we got Father's Day.
In a
Anything,
bag.
Any price. How much do you love your father?
Yes. Exactly.
We can get you fixed up.
These, and I want one of these, and I want four of those.
We've got the Honda lawn mowers, we've got Honda generators, weed eaters. They've got this new weed eater here, Darren. This is real cool because this has got attachments that go onto it. You can add a weed eater to it, you can add a blower to it, a tiller, an edger, a cutter, or even a tree saw to where you can add these on, $129.
Look at that!
And you got it all.
A chainsaw on a stick!
Massacre! You gotta do your yard work before you can recreate. We all know that's the way it works.
Now, if you want something a little bit nicer, you could like get a new Razor high lifter, for instance, right?
Man, you know, everything.
I'm pretty certain that most fathers, if they get up Sunday morning and this is in their driveway, they're gonna be better dads.
I'm thinking they're never gonna expect anything ever again for Father's Day if they had this year, because you wouldn't top that. We got street bikes, blowout sale on our street bikes this year. We're trying to simplify our lineup a little bit, you know, $4,200 right here. You know, I got some $5,000 bikes over here, clear up to $25,000 for the Goldwing and everywhere in between.
Bullet bikes to cruisers.
All of them, yep.
Touring bikes. So
yep.
Yeah,
and they're all on sale.
So Russ, you have all these toys here. What do you want for Father's Day?
Everything.
Everything. Now, you know,
two wheels. First of all, it's gotta be two wheels. The older I get, the more susceptible I am to getting a concussion. So probably a good helmet.
A good helmet.
Yeah.
Everybody needs a good helmet.
There you go. When Russell was 30, he'd been married for 5 years, he got a concussion, and he had him take him to his parents' house.
All right, Dave, we're gonna put you on the spot.
Okay.
What is it that you want for Father's Day?
Oh, you know, all these toys. I want a new dirt bike.
I want one that I can mount that mountain thing on.
That's an agenda for me too, the snow bike.
Yeah.
I think my choice is a 450 Honda. I'm riding a 13 now. I think I'll be waiting for a 17 here in the fall. I'm supposed to make some changes. I can't wait. I think I'm on the front of the list, but I might get bumped by a paying customer. You never know. They're the new craze for the desert right now.
They're the Ferrari of the desert.
That's what they seem to be, exactly.
So get out here to Steadman's in Tooele. They got all the toys for either work or play. But right now, we need to get to a commercial break.
It's out there. Something is definitely out there. Whatever it is, it's big. At one point, I swear, we got so close I could smell it. But then, poof, it was gone.
Right.
It exists, the new Honda Pioneer 1000 with the best-in-class engine and 6-speed fully automatic dual-clutch transmission. Pioneer 1000 from Honda.
There's a little place on a Utah map where I was raised, where my heart's at, where the sagebrush grows wild and high and the stars come out at night. Oh, there ain't nothing like being raised in the basin with a Ute reservation, skiing starvation, that Duchesne County life.
It's inches off the ground. It's open air freedom. It's remarkably powerful. It's totally unique. It starts at $21,199. It's Slingshot, pure driving fun.
Rediscover your sense of adventure. Welcome to San Juan County. Discover the past. A change of place. Utah, San Juan County, where life is elevated.
Welcome back to At Your Leisure. Now, earlier I had mentioned the movie Gentle Ben, the TV series with Dennis Weaver. I used to watch it when I was a kid back in the late 60s. Dennis Weaver was a ranger in the Everglades, and they didn't have a car, they had an airboat like this. And I thought, you know, I always want to go. Oh, we're about ready to run over an alligator. Right next to him. Don't put your hand out. Anyway, they had a car. They went and said, I want to do that someday. I want to go zipping through the Everglades in an airboat. And guess what? Right now, I'm going to get to do it. So let's find out how much fun it is. Your protection.
By far, the park offers the best airboat ride you can get. They do 360 spins out there, and I know all the airboat drivers personally. Drove with them myself. It's a lot of fun.
I feel like I'm on a Disney ride. It's all mellow, and I'm waiting for little pirates to pop out.
Now I understand why Dennis Weaver would not have a car out here. This is way more fun. Was that a blast? Did you get dizzy out there? Because I sure did. I want to do it again. I want an airboat. Anyway, right now, we're going to go to our trailhead adventure. Now, usually our trailhead adventures are pretty exciting. They're going to have to work real hard to outdo what we just saw. However, we're going to give it the old AYL try. Here you go.
We're back once more on the old trail, our own trail. Rudyard Kipling wrote those words in a poem about life's travels through the wilds of the world. That imagery of trails and the unknown is a part of Western culture and our drive to get off the beaten path in search of new horizons. Today, a group of old friends are doing just that, riding trails, new and old, in an attempt to relive past memories.
We grew up on motorcycles, and we raced and we rode and you know, as we got older, we transitioned to four-wheelers. We can get back to the good old days where we've all had fun together, and this is just an excuse to bring us all together.
We come down here about twice a year, and we try to enjoy all of the areas. Just the different landscapes that you can see within a day, they vary from one extreme to another.
We all have a common bond that we love to be out in nature and just enjoy it. And being able to get back into the country, not just driving down the highway and seeing what you can see there, but to get back in there and actually feel what it's like to be back here.
The group has chosen trails that lead into the Grand Staircase Escalante National Monument for this year's adventure. Roads here have been controversial since the creation of the monument in 1996, with some routes being closed to off-highway travel that were previously open. Many of the roads are contested by the county as RS-2477 right-of-ways that were always to be open for public access. Several of those claims have been challenged, and the trails closed across BLM and Forest Service lands. The group today doesn't dwell on the lost acreage, instead focusing on where they can ride and what they can see. But the images of past reunions still linger in their minds, memories of adventures that can never be recreated with children and grandchildren.
There's definitely a balance that we have to be careful in, and to articulate that balance. So we're cautious about staying on existing roadways and And yet without that access, you would only see a fraction of the country that's available to see. And when you get out here and away from it all, then you start appreciating just exactly the magnificence that we live among.
I know that there are people that abuse the land, but they can't lump everybody into one group, because there are people that use it and love it and respect it.
Public lands belong to every American citizen, but when disputes erupt between user groups, it's easy to point fingers and lay blame. The knee-jerk reaction of us against them clouds the issue and can turn the image of public lands into one of our lands and their lands. And some feel as if they personally have a claim on certain areas that trumps all others. It's a problem that extends beyond just government agencies and motorized users.
I worked for Provo City, and we had access into an area called Big Springs. And then a property owner acquired the land that you had to cross to get to it. And even though we had a right of way across that to get back there, they had a trailer sitting there, and the lady actually had a 30-30 she set across the doorway just to let us know that that was her property. And more or less, she was allowing us to cross her property. And those kinds of things, I think, are ridiculous. We all have access. It's public lands back in there, and people should have the right to get back to it.
The debate over how to protect and use public lands will continue beyond the foreseeable future, affecting trails and access. But today isn't about what has been lost so much as about what is still here, as friends, new and old, discover the beating heart of what makes the West a symbol of freedom and discovery.
This is our land. It's not the government's. It's ours. And I think that we should be able to have a say in what happens here. I think that we need to respect it. I think we need to take care of it and love it and use it.
This beautiful country, and it's here to be used and enjoyed and for people to take part in. And it's only going to better ourselves if we can do more of it, and that's why that access is so important.
Get off the thoroughfare, stop trying to get from point A to point B as quick as you can, and get back and enjoy what's out there.
That is what these lands are here for, after all, and why everyone is invited to find the old trails, our trails. From the vistas of the Southwest, I'm Terry Wood.
Utah Farm Bureau has always been there to fight for the needs of its members, with discount programs on items ranging from vehicles and ATVs to health and wellness. The membership fees aren't big, but the results are. We've been around since 1916, and we're not leaving anytime soon. Utah Farm Bureau. We work for those who work to feed the world.
I'm Chris Haller, Utah Division of Parks and Recreation Off-Highway Vehicle Program Coordinator. And today we're here to talk about how you can protect your brain. A couple key things when selecting a helmet is to make sure that it's DOT approved and that you check the expiration date. Yes, helmets do expire. Typical expiration date is between 5 and 7 years. Visit our website at ohv.utah.gov for more helmet information. Utah State Parks, adventures for everyone.
Have you ever wanted to go on a vacation to Mars? What about a visit to the Old West? Impossible, right? Well, forget what you think is real. In southern Utah's Kane County, other worlds are just an ATV ride away. The Old West lives on in every sunset. From the downtown streets of Little Hollywood to the vistas that have inspired the world, never find yourself closer to home and yet farther than you've ever been. Southern Utah's Kane County, where anywhere is possible.
Look how cute the little turtles are!
Yes, I keep wanting to see them dive for these things, though, not just float around on the surface.
I'm just hoping there's not like a loose alligator running around in there, because they're going to be like lunch.
Turtle soup.
Yeah.
Indeed. In fact, it kind of is the color of turtle soup right there.
Right.
Welcome back to At Your Leisure. We are at the Everglades Alligator Farm in the Everglades National Park. This has just been so much fun today. I wonder where Steven is. Do you think the snakes
He's still playing with the snakes.
I'm here.
Ah.
Just got done with the snakes. What are you guys doing?
I thought I was looking for a boa constrictor with a large round thing in the middle.
I would take it home. Otherwise, other than, you know, it's as big as my kids. And
I think your wife would say no.
Yeah. So what are you guys doing?
Feed a turtle.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what did you think today, Rhea?
I thought it was really cool. I mean, this place, it has everything. You know, when you come here, it's like you're really experiencing the Everglades, right? You get everything you see in Everglades. You get the ride and the boat, the airboat ride, and you get the alligators and the snakes and the birds, and it's cool.
What was your favorite part, Steve?
I really like the snakes, obviously. Yeah. That's always cool. It's a fun experience. But I think my favorite was the airboat, too. That was just a blast with them whipping around. And
you loved it.
Yeah, well, that would be my favorite part, because anybody that's watched since the beginning of Boat World 22 years ago know that I would go for the boats. The only problem I had, couldn't drive.
Yeah, there's too many people on the boat. Yeah. They're afraid you're going
to
roll it.
True. Now, if you would like to take a vacation and come down here, Miami-Dade County Tourism and Travelers Bureau has a lot of information. We'll give you a link on our website. And don't just plan to come for a day or so and add it to your Fort Lauderdale trip. There's enough to do out here between the Keys. I mean, Key Largo is just like another 30 minutes down the road.
Yeah.
And Key Biscayne, where all the beautiful reefs are, go for a glass bottom boat ride. It can keep you busy for 3 days. Your family will love it. Your kids will learn things they never imagined.
Yeah.
You're gonna bring Becky and the kids back?
I will. Take them here.
Yeah, they'd love it.
Well, we got a long list of things to do, right? What's in front of us?
Well, we got travel planner.
Yep.
We giveaway winner.
Yep.
Next week's show.
I guess we better get to it.
All right. Well, our winner is Steve Milner. He posted this photo on Facebook. You can see his AYL sticker right there. Steve, congratulations. You are the winner of a family four-pack to Fast Carts. This is a great family activity. You can race in the go-karts. Have a great time. Call us at 801-947-8888 to claim your prize. Now, how about we take a look at next week's AYL episode?
Well, in 1 week, come with me, Darren Kinder, along with my wife, Jill, as we take a motorcycle trip through the Dakotas. Why is now the perfect time to hit the open road across the country? We'll show you. From there, Ree Stein hits one of the less famous national parks and discovers why sometimes the best adventures can be found in the quieter sections of the world.
Well, it looks like a great show next week, gentlemen.
Sure does.
It does indeed. It's been a great show this week,
It has, and I love you guys so
much. I love you, too. Group hug.
All right, son. Listen.
Too much sun.
Too much sun. We would love to invite you to come down here. It's simple to remember to come to the Everglade Farm. It's everglade.com.
I can remember that.
Good. So look for it. We'll look for you next time we all get together on our next adventure.
Yes.
What are we going to do?
We're going to hug.
No.
Let's go. Come on. You guys are just way out of line.
Heat stroke, I tell you. It's heat stroke. Today, I am at Alligator... Oh, Crapples. Park, and there's guys like Luke that make it a hell... Heck... Blah. 3, 2, 1.
I'm going to talk when the camera's not looking at me.
No, just do it. Just give it up, Dave. Just give it to me.
Hi, I'm Chad Booth from At Your Leisure. I hope you just enjoyed the YouTube video that you just watched. Now, remember, we come up with new videos like this every single week, so you might want to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you never miss a single story that we have out. Now, you can also share us with all of your friends on social media. Here's how to do it right here, and that way they can have fun too. If you want detailed information, we of course have our website, ayltv.com. And from there, you can find out which television stations we broadcast on, so you never have to spend a day without your fix of family-oriented outdoor recreation adventure. Plus, don't forget, we have really cool contests.